Gangadhar, please start.
Gangadhar sir, let's speak something. Gangadhar sir.
Maybe he has network issue. Somebody else take over immediately.
Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am.
What happened to you, Gangadhar?
Yes.
Yes, please speak. Somebody speak.
Hello, Gangadhar, sir. Hello. Sir, Joshi, sir.
Hello, Gangadhar, sir.
I think he may not be. Hello, children.
Hello, sir. Good afternoon.
Hello. Good afternoon, children. How are you?
Fine, sir.
Thank you. Now, children, now I'm going to show you some pictures. What is this? What is this?
This is a picture of a blind man.
Blind man, yeah, yes, blind man. Then, next one picture. What is this?
He's a lame boy.
Lame boy or a physically challenged person. Yes. Next picture. Then, what is this?
Old man.
This? Old man, sir.
Yeah, yeah, of course, an old man. Then, what is this? In the picture, what do you see in the picture?
Happened with the boy, sir.
Yeah, it's a road accident. Then, dear students, what will we do when we come across these situations? What can we do? How do we help them?
We have to help them.
Yes?
We have to help him, sir.
If we came across these situations, no? Yes?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. The road, and then if they injured, take them to the nearby hospital.
Yes, yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Offer money to them, buy new class to them, and moreover, help them to reach their house. Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
Now, ask you one question, Ananda. Does everyone do the same thing? Is it possible for everyone?
No, sir.
No, because.
No, sir.
Because. Sometimes we have an urgent work, so we should leave the place at once without helping such people. Okay. Nowadays, what happened, you know, people are very busy, but if it is possible, we should help such people. You know, people don't have any time. They are very busy in their own work. They don't want to pay attention to us others. But if it is possible, we should pay. You know, we should help such people. Okay? Then,
okay, sir.
We should live each day being kind and helpful towards others and making small contributions to improve their lives. As the good deeds done by us today will earn us our tomorrow. Okay, children? Here, okay, in this poem, the somebody's mother, the poet is trying to convey through this poem, if you help others, one day your own mother could be in similar situation and someone else could help her. So, we should, you know, we should not be cold-hearted towards others. We should lend a helping hand to those in needy people. Okay. Let's know about the poem, Somebody's Mother. This poem is written by Mary O'Brien, a poet and an author and a lyricist. She was born in New York, United States. She has provided lyrics for the famous piano piece, Hearts and Flowers. She was died in 1913. Now, children, dear children, look at the page number 92 of your textbook. Now I'm going to read the poem. What is this? The woman was old and ragged and gray, and bent with chill of winter's day. The street was wet with recent snow, and the woman's feet were aged and slow. She stood at the crossing and waited long, alone, uncared for amid the throng of human beings who passed her by. Now heeded the glance of her anxious eye. Down the street with laughter and shout, glad in the freedom of school let out, came the boys like a flock of sheep, hailing the snow, piled high and deep. Passed the woman, so old and gray, hasn't the children on their way, nor offered a helping hand to her.
He joined back.
He paused beside her and yes, ma'am.
Nothing, sir. Continue.
Lest they carry as wheels or horses, feet should crowd her down in the slippery street. At last came one of the merry troop. The gayest lady of all the group, he paused beside her and whispered low, I will help you across. If you wish to go, her aged hand on his strong young arm, she placed, and so without hurt or harm, he guided the trembling feet along, proud that his own way firm and strong. Then back again to his friends he went, his young heart happy and well content. She is somebody's mother, boys, you know, for all she is aged and poor and slow. And I hope some fellow will lend a hand to help my mother. You understand, if ever she is poor and gray, when her own dear boy is far away, and somebody's mother bowed low her head in her home that night, and the other prayer, the prayer she said was, God be kind to the noble boy who is somebody's son and pride and joy. Thank you, sir. Now I wanted to hand over Mrs. Gayatri, ma'am.
Yes,
Gayatri, ma'am, continue. Yeah, this is somebody's mother, ma'am.
Hello. Do you like this poem, children?
Yes, madam.
Yes, ma'am.
Why do you like this poem?
Because, you know, the poem has...
Why do you like this poem?
It is about the boy who helps an old woman, madam.
Very good. Poem, we come to know the boy and the old lady. Okay. And what do you all understand? What are the words you come to know in your mind when you listen this poem?
Help, madam. Old woman.
Okay. Let us see. Let us see what is the poet explaining the beautiful summary of the poem. Let us see. Before we are going to retime the poem, let us see the glossary. Rag, clothes, baggy, short. Chill means unpleasant cold. Storm means proud. Heated means paid attention. Sailing, welcoming. pile. Put one on another. If they move the feet, meek, mild, is daddy. This boy, fast, waited, stop for a while. This is for our Santa boy. The woman was old and ragged and gray and went with the chill of the winter day. The street was but with a recent snow and the woman's feet were bathed in snow. So what do you understand here? How was the woman look like? How was the woman look like in this stanza?
She was old, ma'am.
Yes, she was very old and her dress was
she was
rag.
Old woman, ma'am.
What does the word rag indicate?
Word.
Rag indicate a poor woman.
Okay. Poor woman.
So, you understand this one, Ms. Santa?
Yeah.
Yes, madam.
The next Santa, she stood at the closing and waited long and even unclicked her. Amid the throng of human beings passed her by, not with the glance of anxious eye. So where she was standing?
The road, ma'am.
She was standing at the crossing, ma'am.
She was standing
at the crossing, ma'am.
To cross the road. Very good. Yes. So she was anxiously waiting for someone will help her. Was waiting there. Okay. She was waiting for a long time. And let us see. Move on to the next stanza. Down the street, the laughter and shout, glad in the freedom of cool it out. In the voice like a flock of sheep, hiding the snow, fine, white, and green. So here, what do we come to know? Explain about the children. So who maybe the children are? They are school children. They may be school children. So how they are coming out of the school?
They are coming like a flock of sheep, ma'am. Flock of sheep, ma'am.
Oh, okay. Beautifully explained. Compare.
Like a flock of sheep.
Okay. So they are coming with a laughter and shouting.
Yeah.
They are very happy coming out of the school. Yes. Past the woman so old and gray, hastened the children on their way, nor offered a helping hand to her, so meek, so timid, so upright, so safe. So there, she was waited for a long time. The children are coming. Many of the people are passing here. So nobody is caring. Nobody is coming. Trying to find children. Understand, children? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, madam.
Next, yes. The weak on the horse's feet, she crowd her down in the slippery street. At noon, she came in one of the merry schools. The gayest laddie is all the bull. So, who was the gayest laddie here? One of the gayest
yes, ma'am.
Happy.
Very good. Happiest boy. One of the happiest boys among the boys. Okay. So, she listens to the, what is the animal here? Carriage wheel or the? What? Horses? Dingy. Okay. Yes. Merry troop here. Who is the merry troop?
Boys, madam.
Yes, very good.
School children, ma'am. Yeah, school children.
Boy. Yes, very good. Next. So they are coming like that. Very shouting, the dog is laughing with the keeper beside her and whispered, no, I will tell you a show. And this song and face and show without earth or so he looked at the old woman and he came forward and he will whisper me in a whisper me
murmuring slow voice, madam.
Voice in a murmuring voice. He said, I will tell you. Your high, I refer to
the boy, madam.
I refer to a boy. So he comes and says, so I will help you. Okay. And he helps her to cross the road. So next scene, what happens? He guided the jumping feet along, proud that his own work, firm and strong, and back and right, friends to them, they are happy and content. So finally, what we did? Children?
Yeah, ma'am. The boy helped the woman to cross the road, ma'am.
Yes, very good. He helped her to cross the road. So he guided that old lady, don't worry. Okay, I'm with you. I will help you to cross the road. And he said, without any harm, he helped her to cross the road. Next, somebody's mother, boy, no, but all she ate and food and slow. And I go, come below the lend a hand to help my mother to understand. If ever she is poor and sick, when her own dear was far away. So, what happened next? Evening? Oh, she went home. And what she did there? What she is recalling that about the boy at home. So he is a somebody's mother. Sorry, he is somebody's son. Okay.
Yeah.
So hey, today he is very feeling very badly. Okay. Next. And somebody's mother bows her, bows low her head, her foot at night, prayer she says, would God be kind to the little boy who is somebody's son, right? God. So, what did she pray in that prayed that night?
She prayed for the boy, ma'am.
God be kind to the noble boy.
She prayed
to the noble boy. So, this is the summary of the poem. Do you like this summary?
Yes, madam.
Children, do you like this?
Yes, madam.
Yeah, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So, what we have to do? So, yeah, what we understood, what is the theme of the poem here?
We should help the needy people, ma'am.
Yes, we should help always the needy people. Okay. So, I will provide you some worksheets now. Okay. So, I will you give me the answer. The woman in this poem was that.
Old woman.
How she was looking, physical appearance.
She was old, madam. She was wearing ragged clothes.
Yeah. Okay. So why she was waiting near the road?
No, she wanted
someone help to cross the road.
She was waiting for somebody would come here and help her.
The woman was helped by who?
The boy, madam.
The boy here compared to a dash.
Flock of sheep, ma'am.
Flock of sheep. Very good. So, tomorrow, okay, learn this poem, okay? Hello?
Yes, madam.
Read this poem, okay?
Yeah.
Come tomorrow. Okay. Sir?
Thank you.
Thank you, Gangadhar madam. Thank you, Gayatri madam. Okay, please, everyone, mute your mic. Dear children, did you enjoy the poem?
Yes.
Of course.
Yes.
Of course,
yes.
You have enjoyed, I think. So please, sir, mute the mic for everyone. I think you enjoyed. So let's make the poem more enjoyable. Let's have a small fun with these kind of a word game. Dear children, Yes. Have written five sets of words on the board. Sir, sir, please, sir, mute the mic. Dear children, I have written five sets of words on the board. I will read the first word and you have to say the second word, which was prior to that word. Okay, start. Shall we start? Okay, I will say the first one. You have to say the second one.
Yes.
I say ring.
Sing.
That's right. It's a thing. Then pet.
Net.
Of course. Net.
Yes.
Yeah. Ban.
Hand.
Hand.
Yes.
Ban.
Tank.
Gate.
Late.
Dear children, did you find something differ or similarity between these kinds of words?
Yes,
sir. Yes. Yes, of course. What is the common between these words?
Sound.
Yes, yes, you say it. That's the right answer, sound. But these kinds of words having same sound at the end of the sound, these kinds of words are considered or called as rhyming words. Rhyming words, they may be two or more. These kinds of words have the same or similar ending sounds, not the beginning sound. For example, ring, sing. The first sound of the first word is r. Second sound is ing. Both them pronounced as ring. Second one, first sound is, second sound, ing. That makes sing. Similarly, second pair of words, first sound is b. Second sound is and. Both them make band. Again, second word, first sound, h. Second sound, and. Both of them make hand. Ring, sing, band, hand.
Hand.
So
yes.
Similarly, these kinds of words, most of the poems having them, we are using these kinds of rhyming words, most of the poem, to make that poem more enjoyable to recite or read. So most of the poems having these kinds of sounds at the last of each line, maybe last of the each line. While you are going to figuring out or searching these kinds of words, rhyming words, you have to use your ears. You have to listen what the words like pronounce, and you have to say the words. Let's have read this poem, this stanza. Okay, the woman was old and ragged and gray, and bent with the chill of winter's day. The street was wet with the recent snow, and the woman's feet were aged and slow. So the children, do you find rhyming words? Yes, of course, there are rhyming words.
Yes,
I have,
sir,
given two words. I have written two words on the board, and let's find out rhyming words for each of them. Okay, let's read out
the
first two lines. The woman was old and ragged and gray, and bent with the chill of winter
day.
Gray day.
Day.
At the end of the first line, the word is gray, and gray is end up in second line. Gray and day. Both the words having similar ending sounds. And what about snow? Read again 3 and 4 lines. The street was a wet with the
woman's feet were
snow.
Slow, sir.
Woman's feet were aged and slow. Snow. Snow. Gray. Day. Snow. Slow. Isn't interesting? Yes, of course. These kinds of rhyming words always make the poem interesting. And one more point is that I have something interesting that, let's go to, you have to go to that your poem and you have to open the textbook page number 92, find the missing word. Okay, I have written half of the line, half of the sentence given on the in the poem, we have to find out the missing word.
Yes, sir.
Boys, did you get getting?
Yes, sir.
Go to page number 92, third stanza. I think you have got those missing letters. Did you get it?
Yes, sir.
Did you get?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Can the boys like it?
Letters?
Yeah, like a flock of sheep, sir.
Very good. Like a flock of sheep. Okay. As early Maran told about that, in this poem, boys are there, but there is no mention of sheep. But here, poetess used or compared boys to flock of sheep. Flock
yes.
means group. Andre gumpu. Athava Hindu.
Yes.
Then
yes.
sheep means kurigal. Flock of sheep means kurigala. Again, in this poem, here the poetess wanted to compare these boys were walking or moving like flock of sheep. That means the boys here are uncared for anyone, uncared for anything. In those boys were moving like flock of sheep. Directly the poetess yes. is comparing the boys to sheep of wool. These kinds of comparisons are called as figures of speech. Figures of speech we use in figurative languages. Okay, we use figures of speech or these kinds
yes.
of comparisons we use in our spoken languages or in most of the poems also. Because here the poet or poetess wanted, reader has to imagine or understand much more than a single word or plain word saying. That means simply the poetess wanted to say that the boys can move. The boys may be moving, but here she wanted to emphasize or focus on how the boys were moving on. That's why she used like a flock of sheep. So these kinds of comparisons are considered or called as figures of speech. I think we have enjoyed, we have learned many things, and let's focus on some questions. I have written some questions on the board. I will read out the first question and try to answer those questions.
Yes.
First one is, what kind of a woman do you find in this poem?
The woman was old.
Bad. Old, sir. The woman was
okay.
very old.
Very good. We can find an old woman.
Yeah.
Second question, where was the woman standing and why?
So she was standing at the cross. She wanted to cross the road, sir.
Very good. She was standing at the cross of the road. She wanted to cross the road, but she was hesitated because
yes.
of the moving vehicle. So that's why she needed some help. Then third one, what
yes.
did the boy tell his friend?
If today we helped somebody's mother, so other day someone will help my mother.
Okay. Right. Very good. The boy says to his friends that today I help
yes,
someone.
Sir.
Someone will help my mother when I am away from my mother. So their students note down these words and make work on them and present in next class. The first question is, do you like the poem? If you like, why did you like this poem? If you don't like, why didn't you like that poem? You have to discuss with your friends
yes.
and you have to present in next class. And second
yes,
question,
sir.
Pick out the rhyming words in the poem and read aloud with your friends. Have enjoy with those rhyming words. Thank you. Thank you, one and all. Thank you, Uzma Madam. Thank you, Gangadhar sir. Thank you, Gayatri Madam.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Gangadhar, what happened
to
Joshi?
No
video? Yes, madam.
No video.
Madam, sorry.
Video.
Yes, ma'am.
Cameras. Oh, okay. Fine. Okay. Good presentation. Now, the first person who presented here, the poem, Gangadhar, your face wasn't visible, but then we could see the screen. And then the poem, did you notice the team members?
Yes, sir.
Joshi and Chandrasekhar, the stanzas were repeated. If you just go to the first slide and see there again, that yellow one. The stanzas were repeated and some stanzas were missing. So when you're showing it, or both the sides, it is the same. What?
We are facing a network problem here.
Sorry, madam. It was this second.
No. Both the sides, it was the same part.
Yes, madam. It's stanzas are repeated, madam.
So that shouldn't happen. Okay,
yes,
so when you're displaying,
I have typed somewhere and I copied it, madam.
Yes.
So that's it.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay.
Yeah. Anyway, Joy, J-O-W, please say Joy. Not Jai.
Joy.
Yes, it's a joy. Good. The reading was there and then a lot of discussion, interaction was there. Towards the end, you came up with figures of speech also.
That's fine.
Yeah, try to... I'll